Well, 25 days ago, you couldn't escape the news of Hurricane Harvey. And get this, as of tonight, Harvey was 4 hurricanes ago.
Yeah, it's numbing in a way, right, to see what Harvey did to the Gulf Coast, only to get slammed 2 weeks later by Irma. And now to watch Jose form into a monster and see Maria devastate the Caribbean. So what's the deal here? Is this the worst ever? I sat down with a climate scientist to find out.
As of tonight, the Atlantic hurricane season is running at twice the pace of what is called an average season. We've had 7 hurricanes and 6 other major storms. If we get 2 more this year, 2017 will go down as one of the top 15 hurricane years since 1851. That is startling enough, but y'all, the real story here is the quality of the events we've seen this season and not the quantity.
The message to get across is we're not seeing more of them, but we're seeing more intense ones.
Dr. John Abraham has studied ocean warming and climate for years, and he's watching now more than ever. To prove his point on intensity, think about this. In 2005, when we had more Atlantic storms than names to give them, the damage to our country financially was $143.5 billion. That was the year of Katrina and 3 other hurricanes. Now, in the last month, Harvey and Irma have hit, just 2 storms. Those have already cost us nearly $300 billion.
This is a debris field.
And we're not even counting what's going on right now, Hurricane Maria. That is crashing into Puerto Rico tomorrow, a storm the governor of that U.S. territory calls the biggest and potentially most catastrophic hurricane to hit there in a century. So, it's time to get to what many climate scientists, like Dr. Abraham, believes is the why.
Climate change is affecting the severity. We are warming the planet. Most importantly, we're warming the oceans. We've warmed the oceans by almost 2 degrees Fahrenheit, and that means that these storms have more power, more energy.
2 degrees of warmth sounds like nothing, right? Well, it's not nothing when you think about what makes a storm, a hurricane. Ingredient number 1 is warm water.
Warm ocean waters create and drive hurricanes. They're actually the engine that powers the hurricane. The way it works is these hot waters evaporate from the ocean surface and then they recondense up in the atmosphere. The warmer the water, the more that process happens. So it's true, warmer waters give you stronger storms.
Which in short takes us back to point number 1.
The best science out there tells us there won't necessarily be more storms, but there will be more severe storms. So it's not that the numbers will go up, but the numbers of Irma's will go up and the numbers of Harvey will go up.
And then leads to a more ominous question.
But what scientists want to know is this a 1-year blip, or does this foretell trends to come? And we just don't know for sure, but it doesn't look promising.
Obviously the oceans aren't going to cool in the immediate future, and right, not looking promising as hurricane season goes to November 30th. So those big questions about not only the human cost of these hurricanes, but $300 billion in 1 month, how are we going to pay for that? We already had bailout FEMA for just 1 storm from Harvey.
Right, and that's just, I mean, you're talking about lives and infrastructure, but then think of all the businesses that are destroyed, and those people's lives are, you know, financially ruined. And, you know, so it's just the ripple effect is amazing.
And the rebuild, right? Yeah. So if you're a company, would you rebuild in parts of Florida or Houston, or would you think twice about that?
Well, I mean, especially if this is going to keep happening
long term. Yeah,
you,
big
you
consequences.
Might change your mind. Yeah, interesting. All right.